We'll get going after the announcements, folks. Just have your BellWorks, your planner is good, your homework in your planner, please, and your BellWork ready to go. Oh, sorry, I didn't follow that. What's up? Sharpener? It's same place it always is, by that box. I think so. If it's not there, someone stole it. I'll get you another one. Good? Did you sign up, Chris?
Yeah.
Who's on your team?
Well, they signed me up. So
good.
They signed me up.
Awesome, man. No, I think I tossed them. Yeah. Yeah. Do I have a pencil? Yeah, give me just a second. I'll get you one, okay?
I just need my cane and everything. I forgot it was.
Oh, okay. No worries. I'll get you. Here. I'm going to get you a pen for now, okay? I'll get you a pen in a minute, or a pencil in a second. Hey, Chris. Sorry, John. Excuse me, brother. I'm gonna grab this cord from underneath your bag. Thanks. Sorry, I didn't want to get put down. You're good. All right. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Holy cow, I'm happy you're here. I'm looking forward to this day. If you haven't already, write your homework into your planner, please. I'm going to give you a planner check Monday of next week, since I won't see everybody on Friday. Monday of next week, we're going to have a planner check, so that way you get your points for the week. Okay. In addition to that, you have a BellWork question. We've been leading up to this Civil War, and I've been kind of dangling it in front of you. Well, today you're going to get a chance to look at it. So I want you to start to think. I want you to explain two ways you think war, any war, not just the Civil War, but if you're struggling, you can take the Civil War. Explain the way a civil war or any war impacts a country. Okay, I gave you some hints. How might it impact its people? How might it impact the economy? How might it impact its government? Dive in. I'm gonna give you guys 5 minutes to write to that, and then we will discuss it. Today is the 22nd, yep. Good, Chris. Nice job, man. Yeah, good job, man. Good to go? Fantastic. You guys are awesome. Healy, how you coming, man? Another minute? Okay. Maya, how's the ankle? Yeah? Kylie, you got in the game this weekend?
Yeah.
Who you play? Ooh. Sounds like a big game, yeah? Is that your rival? Do I know anyone on the team? Oh, really? Ooh. Let me know who wins that one. Natasha. How's rowing yesterday? Paddling? Good? Yeah. Yes, but not yet. Hold that thought. Okay, let's dive into this. What's one way a war can impact a country? There it is. Gotta break the ice. Kiara. Nice. So those resources, instead of being focused on the people or development or technology, they're forced towards war. Nice. Awesome. What's that? How so? For sure. So again, kind of like the same with Kiara, but a different angle. You're investing that money into the war rather than technology development, production, whatever. Building schools, roads, whatever. Nice, man. Ryan, go for it. X of the war. Nice, man. Very, very cool. Somebody else? No? Kylie, nothing?
A little shy this morning.
Yeah, a little bit. That's all right. We got some start. Madeeb, did you get one?
No?
Tiana? What'd you say?
Maybe because I have the chance of not winning the war.
So what does that mean? So like if they lose, what's the effect of that?
Taken over by whoever.
Okay. So the ruling of that, and if you lose, and let's say you lose, now you have the loss of life or resources like Kiara was saying, and the financial burden that Kainoa was saying, and you lost. That's like the worst thing, yeah? Awesome, fantastic. You guys hit some good ones. That's a great start. We are going to give you a chance to look at three different things today. You guys can see we're in groups. It's been a little while since we've been in groups. It's because we're gonna do station rotation. I was telling you guys this is one of my favorite lessons, and it's because of this. You're gonna see three different stations today, okay? So over here, you have images from the Civil War. You have images from the Gettysburg, from medical tents, and even one gentleman who was photographed after the war is like, this is what happened to me. I won't spoil it for you, but I'll let you see it. You guys can figure that out for yourself. Over here at 2, you'll see a table of statistics, and you'll have population for North and South, which we've kind of looked at a little bit already, and you'll have deaths that happened in the war, and also deaths that happened after the war as a result of. Actually, did you know more people died from their wounds than actually died from the wound? Like, more people died from the disease that comes after trying to heal the wound than the wound itself. Yeah, so we'll look into that today. And then lastly, you'll look at this guy named General Sherman. Has anyone heard of him before? Sherman's March to the Sea. Kainoa, what is that, man? Do you know? Okay. He destroyed everything in his path from the north to the coast of Georgia. And you're going to look at that. And the idea is to look at what impact, it's called the scorched war approach. Means I will burn and destroy every single thing I come across. Crops, tear up railroads, all the above. What effect does that have on the population? Yeah, right? Okay, so Ms. Shirk, anybody else want to pass out, get a chance to walk around? Yeah, come on up, Kiara. Austin, you too? You need to take Nicole's. So one to everybody, okay? So what's coming around to you is what you're going to fill out. You have three different questions for each station. You have three different questions for each station. And for those of you who were observant, you'll notice that each of those is a Costa level question. Starts with level 2, moves to level 3, ends with level 4. Scratch that. Starts with level 1, goes to level 2, and ends with a level 3. The nice part is, I think those questions are all very tangible for you. I think every single one of those is very answerable. I think you can get there, just requires a little bit of thought.
So if everyone can take everything they have on their desk and put it away, besides something to write with, and the sheet that goes to the stations that we just handed out to you, because people are going to be coming to your desks. You want to make it nice and clean. Okay, and you'll notice that there's numbers. So, Chris, what number station are you at? What do you think you're going to go to next? Yeah, okay. So the only difference in this is that Okay, you have 7 minutes for each station. Please take your time in answering the questions. We like complete thoughts, complete sentences, okay? If you're having a hard time with the questions, please ask your table partners first, and then raise your hand and we'll come around and help you. But the stuff on the tables is pretty self-explanatory.
Just one pencil.
Okay? Like I said, everything away besides the one paper you're working on.
You guys have questions about what you're doing before we start? Anything unclear, Elias? Know pretty much what you're doing? Okay. If you forget, directions are on the board up here. Same thing Ms. Shirk just said. 7 minutes per station. You'll have time to answer each question. You'll hear the little beep go off. You've heard it before. You'll rotate. It'll give you 30 seconds to rotate, and we'll do that. You'll have an exit ticket at the end. Our focus, guys, our question of the day is to answer this. We're looking at the impact of the Civil War, so you are going to evaluate that. You're going to have to give me two examples, two pieces of evidence from one of your from your stations to support your claim in evidence. Make sense? Cool. That's how it is. And the goal of this, guys, just so you know, is not for you to just look at the Civil War. We know you're going to have to write that essay, right, next week. We're going to dive into that. And this is part of that. This will help you. But bigger picture-wise, I want you guys to think for yourselves. Right, we just ended a war for 14 years. You know there'll be another one coming down the road. And any current event you can put this thought process to. Right? The idea is do the goals outweigh the negative effects? Does the outcome what we want outweigh what the costs are? So in this case, we know what ended after the Civil War. Oh, don't go cold on me. What went away after the Civil War? Thank you. Yeah, slavery, right? That's the big goal, right? We went toward end slavery, right? Amongst other things, but that became the major goal. So does that goal, does ending slavery outweigh the death, the impact on people, how it affected our economy? Does it outweigh all of those things, okay? Just like now, are the wars we're going to go into outweigh, or the conflicts we go into outweigh the negative effects? Okay? You excited? You awake? Kind of, sort of. All right. Well, let's start. Why don't you start at the station that you're at? I'm going to start the timer for 7 minutes. If you're on the videos, the computers, you're going to have to share for the table. But just hit play. I think they're good to go. Questions before we start? All right. Let's get going then. If you guys have questions while you're working, just let us know. Raise your hand. Number three? Oh, okay.
Like, how can I say about this? Like, what am I supposed to say? Like one picture, like, plenty of people dying after that. What do you think of that? I feel bad.
Okay. Well, I'm going to let you dive in then. If you got more questions, let me know. We do for number two? Okay. So knowing that family members or the dead or wounded would have been seen. So like family members would have seen these pictures. Right? What effect would that have taken on the family? Why do you say that?
Because they want to die. And their family members to die in the war. Because they love the
children. That's exactly it, man. So like when you're seeing I'll say this. I mean, Avi looks a little different than your family, but it's got a nice beard at least, right? So imagine this was your, you know, brother or whatever, right? And in the newspaper, you see this picture of him who's lost his arm. Just like you said, man, you're gonna feel frustrated. You're gonna be mad that this war did this to your family. Absolutely, man, because you love him, just like you said. Cool, yeah, dive in, man, that's awesome. Kalea, how you doing, ma'am? Does it make sense what you're doing? Yeah.
What are the periods today?
It is same as any Wednesday. So they're up on the board if you need them.
Well, it's not block schedule?
No, not block schedule today. Notice the person without the arm. What did you? Which one? This one or this one? I'm looking at your number one. You said you noticed the guy without the arm. What'd you think about it? Kind of gross. Okay. Keep going. Do you know what you're doing for two? Yeah. Okay. Madeeb, how you doing, man?
Good. I thought it was like slightly graphic. I don't know why.
Definitely though. Yeah. Have you tried to go into number two yet? Answer number two. So like, yeah, absolutely. And that's kind of the point, is that they're graphic. And so we knew the camera was invented this time, right? Remember that? So these pictures for the first time are being shown in newspapers. Before, people never saw what war looked like unless they were at war. Like if they were fighting in that war. Otherwise they had no idea. Like mom back home had no idea what war looked like. But now people were seeing these images. This is actually from Gettysburg. This was one of the biggest battles of the Civil War. And people saw this in the newspaper. Like this could have been somebody's, you know, son, brother, cousin, whatever. And people were like, holy cow, that's what it looks like? That's what my son is going through?
Yeah.
Scary, yeah?
Really like to see it in hypothesis format. So,
do
you
what's that?
Remember?
Yeah, totally. So, like, I was just saying this to Majid. So, these pictures, we knew the camera was invented at this time. Remember that? Right? So, for the first time, these pictures are being shown to people in newspapers, like in cities. So, before, nobody knew what a war looked like, what a battlefield looked like, unless they were fighting there. But now, moms and grandmothers are seeing what battle looks like, seeing what a war looks like after the fact. How do you think grandma would feel if she saw this picture in a newspaper?
Those people, you're right, they were harvesting resources, they were in charge of our staff.
Yeah, why?
Because there's people dying.
Definitely. Definitely. And that's just it right there, man. You just answered it. Good. Yes, ma'am. We're going to do that tomorrow. I figure we got enough going on, you know? Watching it again. Right on, gentlemen. Did you guys get finished?
Yeah.
Yes, you're awesome. All right, so that is our bell. So take your paper and your pencil with you. If you're on the video, hit pause. Finish up the last one that you're on. Give you 30 seconds to finish up the one that you're on, and then we're going to, when you're done, rotate to the next station. So 3 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1. Actually, let's go this way. 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1, 4 goes to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 4. Yes, sir. What's up? You trying to figure out what you're looking at? Okay. So you have different numbers from the Civil War. Okay? Civil War statistics. So the first one you're trying to answer question was, what's the most shocking statistic or number that you saw? So you have population for both sides, okay, the North and the South. You have the number of soldiers who fought in the war for both sides. Okay. Soldier casualties. So this is how different people died, different ways people died. Okay. And people who may not have died but were wounded. Okay. And here's the number of how many people actually died total in the war. So over 1 million people died in the war, both from like being shot in battle and their wounds later, the diseases that come of it. Over 1 million people died in just a handful of years. Does that make sense? So, of all this, what to you is like the most shocking? What stands out to you? What are you like, holy cow, that's a lot? The total? Yeah. How about you, John? Of like all of these numbers, total numbers?
Population. No.
Why is this shocking to you?
Because that's how much people died.
Lot, little?
It's like 1 million, then the population is like 22 million.
Yeah, exactly. Like if there's 22 million people plus 9 million, is it 31 million people, about 32 million people total, right? And over a million of those die, that's a lot, yeah? So that's what I want you to write here. So this number, like this total deaths during the war was shocking because of what you just said. You good? All right, brother. 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 4. And we are right on time. Everybody got what they need? Good to go? Questions? All right, 7 more minutes. Final 7 minutes through your station. Tiana, if it's more comfortable, why don't you sit on the other side, then you can, I mean, follow your heart, but if you want to make it easier, maybe. Okay. You know, maybe Elias could be a gentleman and let you stay. Yes, sir.
What does number 2 mean by taken?
Okay, so we know at this time cameras were first invented, right? Remember that from the Inventions Project? Okay. So not only was this the first time pictures were taken of war, but these pictures were also put in newspapers for the first time. So like families and people who have never been to war and don't know what it looks like are seeing pictures of like Gettysburg, which is that battlefield on top, one of the bigger battles of the war. I think most people died in Gettysburg, if I remember correctly. And then, like moms. Think of grandma sees a picture of that battlefield in the newspaper, and, you know, cousin Johnny is right there in front. What effect is that going to have on grandma? You know? What effect is that going to have on the next generation of soldiers? Are they going to be more or less motivated to go to war? I know, right? It's nuts. Yeah. Or maybe he's been sitting there a while and the blood is pooling or something. But yeah, it's graphic though. That's the point though. And like people are seeing these graphic images for the first time. You know, they're seeing what war looks like even if they've never been there. Doing okay? Okay, remember if then because, right? So if something like the overall idea of this, if this thing happens, then this is the effect. Because of this. You still got 4 minutes. I'm going to let you dive into it. But if you get lost, need some help, let me know. Doing all right, Elias? Huh? You know what you're doing? Okay. Good job, Cleo. Yeah. Do you know that's the hardest question that you're answering first? Good job, man. That's killer. Kiara's group's talking to each other to try to understand the question. You guys all done? No? Well, yeah, can I see? If there was a way to avoid death, then we would probably go to war again. Because the soldiers' lives weren't in danger. That makes sense. So for you, the biggest effect, the biggest problem is the number of deaths. If you could avoid deaths, then conflict is no issue for you. That's the problem with war, though, yeah?
Yeah.
I don't know how you would do something like that. That's always the trade-off. Like, yes, we ended slavery, but 1 million people died for the cause. Is that worth it? And that's what I want you to decide. You know what I mean? And not just for this, but just anything that you come across in the future. Like, whatever the goal is, does that outweigh the cost, whether human lives or financially or whatever? What's up, man? You stuck? Which one?
Number 3.
Predict the impact images would have on American people. So, you have these three images, yeah? This one on top is of Gettysburg. It's one of the bigger battles from the war. Okay, like more people died. So that's the actual picture from the battlefield after the fight, the one on top. Okay? The other two are like effects of what happened to soldiers. Because before, you know how like when you get hurt, you go to the doctor, they fix you, right? Well, at this time, they didn't have the technology to fix you. So what do? They cut off the problem. So if you get shot here in the forearm or whatever, instead of just being able to like take the bullet out, give you some medicine, heal it all up, they didn't have that technology. So they just cut it off. So you'll see guys all the time like missing legs, missing whatever. So here's what I'm getting at, Chris. Remember from the Inventions Project, cameras were just invented at this time. Okay? So this is the first time these pictures are being taken. So people are seeing them outside, away from the fight. These pictures are being put in newspapers. So like imagine grandma seeing this picture in the newspaper. What's grandma going to think?
My grandson.
Right. Do you think it's going to make her upset? She's like, oh, I'm so glad Johnny's in the newspaper.
Dead.
Yeah, right? Not the best thing. You know, yes, he's in the newspaper, but it's not for like a good thing. It's not like he got honor roll or something. You know what I mean? So, tell me, how do you think grandma or anyone would feel seeing these pictures in the newspaper for the first time?
Terrified.
Explain why. That's what I'm looking for. Okay, that being our bell, go ahead and finish up what you're working on and head back to your desk. You're going to need your notebook for this one. Yeah. Well, we got 10. Well, we won't get to questions, though.
That's okay.
Okay. All right, friends, if you have anything that is unfinished, go back and work on those. Now we're going to give you 3 minutes to go back and finish any unfinished questions. As soon as my computer works again, I'm going to put up your exit ticket and we'll do that next. So if you finish up early, you can take on the exit ticket questions in your notebook. There it is. Cool. So you have 2 questions for your exit ticket. Looks good, Chris. Proud of you, man. Worked good today, man. Good, Tasha. Regular schedule. Good, Tasha. Kira, I'm going to snag yours for a second. I want to read a couple. Oh, excuse me. Just getting it away from the edge. We'll see, though. We'll see what time allows. Doing okay? Well. Good, Kiara. You really went deep with this. Good job. All of it. Everything. Burning crops, burning stores, burning homes, tearing up roads. Okay? Do you know what you're doing? Do you know what you're doing for this question? Okay. Remember when you were watching the video?
Those are the ones that you had in your
room. Okay. He was tearing up everything in his path, yeah? Why? What's that? How would that help him win?
I don't know what he did.
So remember, he tore up railroads, he burned crops, he burned homes, burned businesses, destroyed everything they came across. Okay, so resupply themselves, like steal supplies. Okay, sure, that's one. If they burn enemy homes, if they tear up enemy railroads, what's it going to keep the enemy from doing?
Hey, how many are we supposed to do?
For number 2, right? If they tear up railroads, and they burn businesses, the enemy's businesses, what's it going to keep the enemy from doing?
Coming to their
land. Yeah, coming back, right? Fixing it, gaining a foothold, getting stronger. So the goal is to keep them from coming back and getting stronger. He wanted to just end it, everything, destroy everything in his path so that they couldn't come back, so they couldn't fight back. Does that make sense? Okay. Keep going, Chris. Good job. He's doing okay. Healy, how you doing, man? Can I see your questions? Okay. This one is good. Actually, all of these are good. They're all just level 1, so. You don't need to erase it. Leave it. Remember? You got? Okay. So now just do a 2 and a 3, and you're there. Doing okay? What you working on? Fabulous.
I don't even know what I'm doing.
Grab your notebook and answer those 2. Yes, yes, ma'am. Fabulous. Okay. Could you write, don't erase this, but could you underneath it rewrite it using one of the words from level 3, cost of level 3? There's one that would fit really nicely into that. Today is the 22nd, yep. Yes, ma'am.
What's his name? The general?
Sherman. S-H-E-R-M-A-N. 45. Yeah, bud, what's up? Or 49. 49.
What does number one mean?
Okay. So, all of these things are from all of these stations. Okay. What... Do you think the Civil War was a good or a bad thing? Why? Okay. So that's one impact right there, that people were getting hurt. Okay? Tell me why that was a bad thing. Why is people getting hurt in a war? Why is that a bad thing? Okay. Loss from their families. What else? Tell me why.
Because the workers are dying.
Dude, yeah, awesome. Write that down. That's the impacts right there. You just gave me two of them. One, it's impacting families because families are losing family members. Two, businesses are going to take a hit because they're losing their workers. Killer, man. Nice job. Yeah. No, thank you. That was awesome. Just three? Just doing level three. Have you tried using the worksheet in your notes to help you?
I remember.
Yeah?
I lost a few questions.
Oh, I'll leave you alone then so I don't make it worse. Can I see? Just need three, level three. Am I missing it? Oh, I see what you did. I see. Sorry, my bad. If the South won, what do you think would happen to the North? North would fight back and forth. So basically, like, number three, are you asking, like, yes, the South wins, Civil War is over, but does that mean all fighting is done? Like, what happens next kind of thing? What do you think would happen? I'm just curious. Let's play that out. What do you think would happen? Okay. So that cause is so great or whatever, they wouldn't just roll over and give up. Interesting. Cool. Who would be leading the charge, do you think, in this anti-slavery crusade?
I don't think that the South would keep Abraham Lincoln. I think they would execute.
Somehow get rid of Abraham Lincoln. If there was a group of people in the North that would lead the charge to end slavery, who would that be?
Probably abolitionists.
Why is that?
That's
their whole cause, yeah. Okay, Noah, how much more you got, my man? Finishing up two. Nice. When you're done, Joshua, when you're done, I'd like you guys to share your level threes. Okay, I'm gonna have you call. I'm gonna ask one of you guys to share one of them. Okay, if you have extra time, see if you can answer it. That's kind of what Jack and I was doing. But take your level three and see if you can answer one of them. Whatever one you guys decide is the best one. Yes, ma'am. What's that?
Is this the worksheet for homework?
Yeah, and it looks like you're done. Yeah. Come on, let me ask you. I'm actually looking for this. I want to see your. Your last questions. Okay, nice. So the positive impact is just like people are seeing the war. Good, Chris. Chris has got out his notes, his Costa level questions to help him write his write his questions. How's it going? You guys, how'd it go?
Good.
Yeah? Of the three of you, which one did you guys have the best through level three? You? Can I see it?
We have the same question.
Same question? That's cool. Same one I read before, or did you end up tweaking it?
Yeah, I kind of did.
What do you think would happen? So slavery, well, not we, but maybe we. Maybe Hawaii would, but the South would for sure, yeah? Do you think that would mean like the end of conflict? Civil War ends, South, saved by the bell. Thanks for playing along, folks. If you're done, turn in your worksheets in the turn-in basket. If you're not done, finish that tonight. I'll collect them tomorrow. Put those in the grade book. Thank you for your hard works today, folks. I'll see you tomorrow. Turn in basket. Turn in basket. Is it done, John?
No. John.